Greetings to you all. I welcome you all to the zoology class, Trends in Economic Zoology, Part 2, Lac Culture. The culture of lac insects using technique for procurement of lac on large scale is known as lac culture. Lac is produced by lac insect Tachardia lacca, previously known as Lacifer lacca. It is a minute, resinous, crawling scale insect which inserts its proboscis into the plant tissues and sucks juice, grows, secretes lac from the hind end of the body as a protective covering for its body. Moreover, the insect is parasite on host plant, that is Karanakalli, Acacia catechu, Karuvelai, Acacia nilotica, Kumbadiri, Sclerichera oleosa. The quality of lac depends upon the quality of the host plant. The female lac insect is responsible for large scale production of lac, which is larger than the male lac insect. Life cycle of lac insect. See the picture. Lac insect lays eggs on the twig of the plant and it catches into larvae, then pupae, then again male and female differentiation, and they used to lay egg, the female used to lay egg. After copulation, the male insect dies. The female develops very rapidly after fertilization and lays about 200 to 500 eggs. Egg catches into larvae after 6 weeks. The mass of emergence of larvae from the egg in search of a host plant is called swarming. After settling on the host, the larvae start feeding continuously and the secretion of lac also starts simultaneously. Gradually, the larvae become fully covered by lac. Then the larvae molt in their respective cells. The shapes of the cells are different for male and female insects. Male are elongated whereas females are oval. Some insects are natural predator of lac insects. The caterpillar of these insects, these parasites, feed upon the lac insects showing hyperparasitism. Lac cultivation is a complicated process, so the cultivators should know well about the inoculation, that is introduction, swarming period and harvesting of lac. The process of introducing lac insect on the host plant is called inoculation. Before inoculation, pruning of the host plant is done. The twigs have broad lac, brood lac, that is lac insect about 20 cm in length are attached to fresh host plants. The lac insect then repeats its life cycle. The collection of lac from the host plant is known as harvesting. Harvesting may be done before swarming, that is immature, or after swarming, that is mature. Immature harvesting produce airy lac, where the mature harvesting produce the mature lac. Lac cut from the host plant is called stick lac. Lac present on twig is scraped and collected. After grinding, then unnecessary materials like dust and fine particles are removed. The resultant lac is called seed lac. Seed lac is sun-dried and then melted to produce shellac. Economic importance of lac. Lac is largely used as sealing wax and adhesive for optical instruments. It is used in electric industry as it is a good insulator. It is used in the preparation of shoe and leather polishes and as a protective coating of wood. It is used in laminating paper board, photographs, engraved materials and plastic molded articles. Used as a filling material for gold ornaments. Hyperparasitism is a condition in which a secondary parasite develops within the previously existing parasite, or a hyperparasite is the parasite whose host is also a parasite. Is it clear? The next topic, aquaponics. Aquaponics is a technique which is a combination of aquaculture, that is growing fish, and hydroponics, growing plants in non-soil media and nutrient-laden water. Aquaponics may also prevent toxic water runoff. It also maintains ecosystem balance by recycling the waste and excretory products produced by the fish. In India, aquaponics was started in the year 2013 only. Some primary methods of aquaponics, phonic gardening that are in use nowadays are as follows: deep water culture, media based method, nutrient film technique, aqua vertica. Deep water culture. See the picture. This is the picture for deep water culture. Deep water culture is otherwise known as raft based method. In this method, a raft floats in water. Plants are kept in the holes of the raft and the roots float in water. This method is applicable for larger commercial scale system. By this method, fast growing plants are cultivated. Second type, media based method. Media based method involves growing plants in inert planting media like clay pellets and shales. This method is applicable for home and hobby scale system. Larger number of fruiting plants, leafy green plants, herbs and other varieties of plants can be cultivated. Third method, nutrient film technique. Nutrient film technique involves the passage of nutrient-rich water through a narrow trough or PVC pipe. Plants are kept in the holes of pipe to allow the roots to be in free contact with water stream. See the picture. Aqua vertica. Aqua vertica is otherwise known as vertical aquaponics. Plants are stacked on the top of each other in tower system. Water flows in through the top of the tower. This method is suitable for growing leafy greens, strawberries and other crops that do not need supporting solid substratum to grow. advantages. Water conservation. No need of water discharge and recharge as the water is maintained by recycling process. Soil. Bottom soil may be loaded with fresh water. Microbes in water can convert the waste material into usable forms like ammonia into nitrates, which are used by plants. Thus, the soil fertility is maintained. Pesticides. In this system, use of pesticide is avoided and hence it is eco-friendly. Weeds. Since the plants are cultivated in confined condition, growth of weed is completely absent. The utilization of nutrient by plant is high in this method. Artificial food for fishes. In this system, plant waste and decays are utilized by fishes as food. So, the need for the use of supplementary feed can be minimized. Fertilizer usage. Artificial or chemical fertilizers is not required for this system since the plant in aquaponics utilize the nutrients from the fish waste dissolved in water. Co-cultivated. Cultivable fishes like tilapia, trout, koi, goldfish, bass, etc. are cultivated in aquaponics. Common cultivable plants like tomato, pepper, lettuce, cucumber and rose are co-cultivated in this method. Aquaculture has been practiced in varying forms for centuries dating to the time of the Phoenicians. India offers a huge potential for aquaculture development. Fish culture received notable attention in Tamil Nadu in 1911. Aquaculture is a branch of science that deals with the farming of aquatic organisms such as fish, mollusks, crustaceans and aquatic plants. On the basis of source, aquaculture can be classified into three categories. They are freshwater aquaculture, brackish water aquaculture, marine water aquaculture. First one, freshwater water culture. Culturing of fishes is called fish culture or pisciculture. In land, water bodies include freshwater bodies like rivers, canals, streams, lakes, flood plain, wetlands, reservoirs, ponds, tanks and other derelict water bodies and ponds constructed for freshwater aquaculture. The pH of the freshwater should be around neutral and salinity below 5 ppt parts per 1000. Brackish water culture. Brackish water fishes spend most of its lifetime in liver mouth, that is estuaries, backwaters, mangrove swamps and coastal lagoons. Estuarine fishes are common in Bengal and Kerala. Culturing of animals in the water having salinity range 0.5 to 30 ppt parts per 1000 are called as brackish water culture. Fish cultured in brackish water are milkfish, channas channas, sea bass, koduwa, grey mullet, madavai, pearl spots, karimeen. Marine water culture. Marine fisheries deals with the fishing operations along sea coast. The Indian subcontinent approximately has a 5,600 kilometers long coastline. About 80% of India's marine fish are supplied by the west coast and the remaining 20% by the east coast. The premier varieties are mackerels, sardines, shark and catfishes. Marine edible fishes of Tamil Nadu coast include both cartilaginous and bony fishes. Culturing of animals in the water salinity ranges from 30 to 35% is called mariculture. Some fishes like channa species, mugil cephalus, are cultured here. Culturing of animals in the salinity ranges from 36 to 40% is called metahaline culture. Example, brine shrimp, Artemia salina. Artemia is commonly known as brine shrimp. It is a crustacean and lives in high saline waters because of its high osmoregularity capacity. Characteristics of cultivable fishes. Fishes should have high growth rate in short period for culture. They should accept supplementary diet. They should be hardy enough to resist some common diseases and infections of parasites. Fishes proposed for polyculture should be able to live together without interfering or attacking other fishes. They should have high conversion efficiency so that they can effectively utilize the food. Types of cultivable fish. Cultivable fish are of three types: indigenous or native freshwater fishes, major carps, Katla, Labio, Clarius. Saltwater fishes acclimatized for freshwater, Channas, Mullet. Exotic fishes are imported from other countries. Example, common carps. Major carps cultivation in India, culture in India. Major carps have proved to be best suited for culture in India because the carps feed on zooplankton and phytoplanktons, decaying weeds, debris and other aquatic plants. They can survive in turbid water with slightly higher temperature, can tolerate oxygen variation in water, can be transported from one place to other easily. They are highly nutritive and palatable, eatable. External factors affecting fish culture. The factors that affect fish culture are temperature, light, rain, water, flood, water current, turbidity of water, pH hardness, salinity and dissolved oxygen. Light and temperature also play an important role in fish breeding. Management of fish farms. To culture fish, one should have an idea about different stages of fish culture, such as topographic situation, quality, source, physical, chemical and biological factors of water, breeding, catching, nursing, rearing and stocking fishes in ponds has to be managed properly. Keeping in view the various stages of fishes, the following different types of ponds have been recommended to manage them: breeding pond, catching pond, nursery pond, rearing pond, stocking pond, harvesting pond. Breeding pond. See the picture. The first step in fish culture is the breeding of fishes. Therefore, for proper breeding, special types of ponds are prepared called breeding pond. These ponds are prepared near the rivers or other natural water resource. Types of breeding. Depending on the mode of breeding, they are divided into natural breeding, induced breeding. Natural breeding. These are special types of ponds where natural riverine conditions or natural water resources are managed for breeding of cultivable fishes. These bunds are constructed in large low-lying area that can accommodate large quantity of rainwater. The shallow area of such bunds is used as spawning pond. Induced breeding. It is an important question. The fish seed is commonly collected from breeding grounds but does not guarantee that all fish seeds belong to the same species. Hence, the advanced techniques have been developed to improve the quality of fish seeds by artificial method of fertilization and induced breeding. Artificial fertilization involves removal of ova and sperm from female and male by artificial mechanical process, and the eggs are fertilized. For artificial fertilization, the belly of mature female fish is held upward. Stripping is done with the thumb of right hand from the anterior to posterior direction for the ejection of eggs due to force. In this way, eggs are collected separately. Further, the male fish is caught with its belly downward. The milt of fish is striped and collected separately, and then the eggs are fertilized. Induced breeding is also done by hypofixation, that is, removal of pituitary gland. The gonadotropin hormone, that is FSH and LH, secreted by the pituitary gland influences the maturation of gonads and spawning in fishes. Pituitary gland is removed from healthy mature fish. Pituitary extract is prepared by homogenizing in 0.3% saline or glycerine and centrifuged for 15 minutes at 8000 rpm rotation per minute. The supernatant is injected. Supernatant means the liquid part above the sediment or precipitate is injected intramuscularly at the base of the caudal fin or intraperitoneally at the base of pectoral fin. Male and female fishes start to spawn, that is release of gametes, and eggs are fertilized. The fertilized eggs are removed from spawning place and kept into catching kappas. Fish seed. Fish seed is collected from breeding pond. The spawn collecting net is commonly called benchijal, shooting net, and transferred to the catching pits. Kappa is nothing but a small a big bowl like structure or big bowl like structure made of mosquito net. The fertilized eggs are kept in catching pits. The catching pit should be near to the breeding grounds, should be smaller in size with good quality of water. There are two types of catching pits. Catcheries are small size pond in which unfertilized eggs are transferred and catching happens. Catching kappas are rectangular trough shaped tanks made up of mosquito net cloth supported by bamboo poles and fixed in the river. Nursery pond. The newly catched fries are transferred from catching kappas to nursery ponds where they grow into fingerlings. Stocking pond. Stocking, you know, stock vehicle. Stocking pond should be devoid of weeds and predatory fishes. Proper organic manuring should be done to increase the production with cow dung, and chemical fertilizer should also be done. Harvesting. Harvesting is done to capture the fishes from the water. Well-grown fishes are taken out for marketing. Small-sized fishes are again released into the stocking pond for further growth. Different methods of fishing are carried out to harvest fishes. These include stranding, angling, traps, dip nets, cast nets, gill nets, drag nets, and purse nets. The harvested fishes are preserved by refrigeration, deep freezing, freeze drying, sun drying, salting, smoking, and canning. Composite fish farming. Few selected fishes belong to different species are stocked together in proper proportion in a pond. The mixed farming is termed composite fish farming or polyculture. Advantages of composite fish farming. All available niches are fully utilized. Compatible species do not harm each other. No competition among different species is found. Katla katla, Labiorogita, Sirenus mirigala are the commonly used fish species for composite fish farming. Exotic fishes, fishes from other countries. Fishes imported into a country for fish culture are called exotic fishes, and such fish culture is known as exotic fish culture. Examples are Cyprinus scorpio and Oreochromis mozambicus. Disease management. Diseases can be of viral or bacterial origin. Regular monitoring of parameters like water quality, aeration, regular feeding, observation for mortality should be checked. Parasitic infections and microbial infections should be observed periodically. Economic importance of fish. Fishes form a rich source of protein, food, and provide a good stable food to tide over the nutritional needs of man. Fish species such as sardine, mackerel, tuna, herrings, and have high amino acids concentration, particularly cystidine, which is responsible for the meat flavor of the fish. It is rich in fat such as omega-3 fatty acids. Minerals such as calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, iron, manganese, iodine, and copper. Some of the fish's byproducts are fish byproducts, fish oil, fish meal, and isinglass. Fish oil. Fish oil is the most important fish byproduct. It is derived from fish liver and from the fish body. Fish liver oil is derived from the liver, which is rich in vitamin A and D, whereas fish body oil has high content of iodine, not suitable for human consumption, but is used in the manufacture of laundry soaps, paints and cosmetics. Fish meal is prepared from the fish waste after extracting oil from the fish. The dried waste are used to prepare food for the pig, poultry, and cattle. The waste obtained during preparation of fish meal are widely used as manure. Isinglass. Isinglass is a high-grade collagen produced from dried air bladder or swim bladder of certain fishes, example catfishes and carps. The processed bladder, which is dissolved in hot water, form a gelatin having adhesive property. It is primarily used for clarification of wine, beer and vinegar. Prawn culture. Macrobacterium rosenbergi. Prawn culture. Most important aquatic crustacean is prawn, which is widely cultured. Prawn flesh is palatable and rich in glycogen protein with low fat content. Types of prawn fishery. Shallow water prawn fishery, located on the west coast, restricted to shallow waters. Estuaries and backwaters are saline lake prawn fishery. The area of production of prawns are the backwaters seen along western coast, Ennur, Puliket, Silka Lake and estuaries of Ganga and Brahmaputra rivers. Freshwater prawn culture. Prawns are captured from the rivers and lakes throughout India. Marine prawn culture. Most of the marine prawns are caught along the Indian coast, belonging to the family Panaeidae. Species of prawn. Number of species of prawn are distributed in water resources such as Pinaeus indicus, Pinaeus monodon, Metapinaeus dobsoni, Macrobrachium rosenbergi. Culture of freshwater prawn. Macrobrachium rosenbergi is commonly seen in rivers, fields and low saline estuaries. The prawn collected from ponds, river, paddy field are transferred to the tanks which are aerated. For fertilization, one pair of prawn are kept in a separate tank. After mating, the eggs are laid. Spawning tanks are of different sizes, should be prepared with proper aeration. Temperature 240 degree centigrade to 300 degree centigrade and pH 7 to 8 should be maintained in the catching tank. The eggs catch into first and second stage larva. Artificial feed is supplied. Young ones of 5 cm length, that is 60 days old, can be reared in fresh or slightly brackish water ponds and rice fields. Harvesting of prawns can be done twice in a year. Culture of marine prawn. Several factors that determine the success of marine prawn culture include selection of site, water quality, soil quality, availability of seed. Preparation of farm. For the preparation of ponds for algal growth and for the subsequent stocking of prawns, it is essential to drain off the water and sun dry the bottom, followed by light tilling. Agricultural lime should be applied to absorb excess carbon dioxide and to supply calcium, which is required for molting. Fertilizers like rice bran, poultry and cattle dung are used to increase fertility of the soil. Prawns are commonly caught in grafts and gills using different types of nets such as cast nets, bag nets, drag nets, trawls, trawl nets and barrier nets. Preservation of prawn is done by peeling and devining or cooking and peeling. Next one is pearl culture. Muttu. Pearl is a white, highly shining globular concretion found within the shell of an oyster. Pearl oysters are sedentary animals. In India, it was cultured for first time in 1973 at Thoothukudi. Pearl oysters found along the coast of Kanyakumari and in the Gulf of Kutch. High quality pearls are obtained from pearl oysters of genus Pinctada that can be cultured in the salinity range of 30 ppt parts per thousand in racks, raft and long line methods. Freshwater bivalve lamellidens is also used in artificial pearl culture. Mostly the pearl oysters inhibit the ridges of rocks, dead corals, forming extensive pearl banks. These pearl beds produce best quality of pearls called linga pearls. When the foreign particle, pearl formation, how they are forming? See, when a foreign particle accidentally enter into the space between mantle. Mantle means the thin membrane and the shell of oyster. Shell of oyster, this dark color shell. Okay, wood. It adheres to the mantle. The mantle epithelium encloses it like a sac and start to secrete concentric layers of nacre around it as a defensive mechanism. Nacre is secreted continuously by the epithelial layers of the mantle and deposited around the foreign particle, and over the period time of formation of repeated layers of calcium. Calcium carbonate makes the hard and glossy pearl. When the pearl enlarges, the oyster dies. The shell is then carefully opened and the pearls are manually separated and graded. Artificial pearl formation or programming of pearl industry and artificial insertion of nucleus. This can be achieved by artificial device to insert nucleus as foreign particle in the shell of oyster has proved useful for the production of pearl in greater number. Collection of oyster, rearing of oyster, insertion of nucleus, harvesting of pearl and clearing of pearl. First one, collection of oysters. Oysters are caught by special type of cages. Dimensions are given by covering a heavy wire frame with 2 cm wire mesh. This cage is dipped into the sand cement mixture, providing rough surface to the cage, to which free swimming spat get easily struck up. These cages are suspended at the depth of 6 meters. From July to November, where spats are easily available, these collected oysters are now transferred to rearing cages. The collected oysters stocked and reared in special type of cage called rearing cage. These cages, as well as protected from the enemies of oysters like octopus, eel, devil fishes, etc. The collected oysters are first cleaned and then placed into the culture cages for the period of about 10 to 20 days to recover from the strain due to excessive handling and for physiological adjustment to shallow water conditions. Now, insertion of nucleus. In this method, a piece of mantle, mantle means a shell of living oyster, is cut off and is inserted together with a suitable nucleus inside the living tissue of another oyster. Following steps are taken for the insertion of nucleus. Fitness of oyster for operation, preparation of graft tissue, preparation of nucleus, insertion of nucleus, post-operation care. Fitness of oyster for operation. The selected oysters for the insertion of nucleus should be healthy, strong enough to overcome the stress during operation. Preparation of graft tissues. Piece of tissues which is inserted inside the mantle is called graft. The outer edge of the graft square must be known because Nasir secreting cells are found only on the outer surface of the mantle. So it is essential to keep the outer surface in contact with the inserted nucleus. Preparation of nucleus. Any small particle may function as nucleus to initiate the PAL formation, but it is reported that calcareous nucleus is the best because the deposition of Nasir was found to be more on calcareous nucleus. Even a small gravel or small soil particle can be enough. Insertion of nucleus. For the insertion of nucleus, the oysters are fixed in a desk clamp in the position for right valve facing upward. Mantle folds are smoothly touched to expose the foot and the main body mass, followed by incision into the epithelium of the foot and a slender channel into the main mass of graft tissue, which function as a bed for the nucleus. Post-operation care. Nucleated oysters are placed into cage and suspended into the seawater and attached with a floating raft to a depth of 2 to 3 meters for about 6 to 7 days to recover from the shocks due to operation. The period of 6 to 7 days is known as recovery period. About 300 to 360 nucleated oysters are kept in the different cage suspended in the seawater at 2 to 3 meter depth for 3 to 6 years and undisturbed except at the time of clearing and inspection. Harvesting of pearl. Pearls are harvested in the month of December to February, which may slightly vary according to climatic condition. After the completion of 3 years of insertion of nucleus, pearl oysters are harvested from the sea, and the pearls are taken out from the shell. Clearing of pearls. After taking out the pearl from the oyster shell, they are washed properly, cleared with the soap solutions. Composition of pearl. Pearl comprises of water, organic matter, calcium carbonate, and the residue. Water 2 to 4%, organic matter 3.5 to 5.9%, calcium carbonate 90%, residue 0.1 to 0.8%. Quality of pearl. The pearl obtained are of variable shapes and size. They may be white or cream, red or pink, red in color. The spherical pearls of rainbow color are rarely found. The best quality of pearl is obtained from the marine oyster. Pearl obtained from freshwater bivalves are not valuable as those obtained from the marine oysters. That's all for today. Thank you.